The inside, three quarters of a length away, Smarty Wilson getting back to fifth on the inside, Ace's Wish, and then Cool Image and Grey Stats around them wider. Jazari is back near the inside, then Alora May and the tail end of Supposition on top of the corner now. 400 left to go. Tiger Red joined by Invincible Warrior. They've come together, two in front. Gunner Go switching back towards the cutaway, and then a gap of about three lengths. Ace's Wish followed then by Alora May and Jazari, but Gunner Go has rushed through at the 200 mark and gone to a clear lead from Invincible Warrior. Supposition from the back of the field making good headway outside Ace's Wish, but Gunner Go draws away and it's no danger for Gunner Go. Gunner Go really running through the line, and he was bomb proof today, beating home Invincible Warrior. Ace's Wish, Supposition in a photo for third from Jazari down on the rail, then a gap of Laura May, Cool Image in the weakening Tiger Red, Grey Stat, and a long last is Smarty Wilson. Number two, Gunner Go, coming away from them, Gun Barrel Straight there. Mitch Pateman aboard. And he's now put together two pretty solid wins, graduating out of his all-age maiden into this 56-plus benchmark ratings race today at Belmont Park. Three starts for two wins. Gunner Go in the colours of It's It, the winner of the Bovine on the weekend for the Roberts team, and has won comfortably from Invincible Warrior, third Supposition just in front of Ace's Wish. The winner, A Trade Fair, Impatient Lass Gelding for Steve Roberts, Mrs. S.M. and D.C. Smith, trained by Jason Pateman, written by Mitchell Pateman, paid $281.70. Invincible Warrior second, A Dogged Effort by the I Am Invincible Chickasaw Gelding for Jimmy Taylor, Jason Brown aboard, $280, and Supposition, a good run from last on the corner, by Hassanay from Coincidental, trained by Chris Gangemi, ridden by Brad Parnham, $2.30. 2, 6, and 4. The SPs, they ran 2.70, Gunner Go, Invincible Warrior, 19. Supposition, $10. 2, 6, 4, 7. Ace's Wish, officially fourth. 1.13.55 there. They clocked for the 1,200. They've run home in 35.26. And Gunner Go, he really did work through the line. He found it strongly today. 2 3/4, the official winning margin by half a length. 2 3/4 and a half. He let down really well once he wound up for Mitchell down on the inside. And he, in certainly the last 100, really did put his stamp on the race. The next event, the Morley Growers Market Handicap, 1,700, 5 minutes after four, 13, 14, 15, 16 are out, 12 starters to go in the third leg of the quaddy as we head back downstairs. And those red and orange colours have been to the fore this week, Adam.
Yeah, they certainly have, Jace. It feels like we're speaking a fair bit at the moment, which I'm sure you're pretty happy about.
Yeah, you can keep that up if you like. I'm happy with that.
Tell us about this horse, a really nice-looking animal we spoke about in the mounting yard. It looks a mile bigger than the rest, and we saw it Northam, a lovely long stride, but he also looks like he's got no idea yet.
Yeah, no, he's a big horse, and he's still progressive type. I think he's still 12 months away from hitting his straps. It's good to pick up a couple of easier ones. He's getting away with it in this class, but I suppose as you step up in class, he's got to start to make sure he's doing it right.
Exciting times, though, as you said, when you've got an animal that is a little bit immature but is still finding ways to win against horses that are a bit older and experienced.
Oh, certainly is. He's, like I said, there's still a heap of improvement in him. I got a high opinion. I think he can go a fair way, yes.
You could tell last start at Northam, the 1,000 was a mile too short. And even today, when it clicks, this looks as though the 12 is going to be too short for him.
Oh, certainly. The first thing I said to owner Steve after the first race, I said, he'll never win another 1,000, I don't reckon. He just got away with it. Yeah.
So what do you do this prep? Do you keep just trying to get some races in and make sure he does click? Or are you going to be a little bit patient and, you know, maybe only one or two more runs before a spell?
Yeah, probably. You're probably right. Probably one or two, maybe. Just why these tracks are soft and that, and because he's a big lump of a horse, probably helping him a bit too, I think.
Exciting times if he's 12 months away, mate. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot, Adam.
Jason Pateman there with another winner. We'll grab Mitchell Pateman as well, who's about to weigh in. And again, another winner for him. He just seems to keep ticking them across at the moment. It doesn't matter where he is in the state. He's riding confidently and he's getting the job done. And again, he gave this one an absolute treat from Barrier 3. Mitch, we just spoke to Jace about it. Very raw at Northam, climbed over the top of them and still very green there.
Yeah, he's very raw. I just said to the owners, he's doing it all on ability at the moment. He's very smart. once he puts it all together, he's going to be a very nice horse.
It looks as though it is a bit inconsistent, but when he is striding out properly, it just looks as though he just takes past him pretty quickly.
Yeah, he's got a lot of ability there. It's just putting it all together. He's, like I say, he's still three and he's still growing and maturing, and he's a big horse and he's very gangly, but yeah, once he puts it together, he's going to really go places.
Put us in the mind of a jockey with a horse like this that is trying to learn, I guess, drawing nice barriers where you can teach him to settle and sit behind horses but then run past him. That must be a big positive as well.
Yeah, he done most of it right today in that sense. He settled well and put himself there and didn't hang in. He probably wanted to head out, if anything, today, but it's just a greenness thing, and sort of once he got in front of the other horses, he got lost, and yeah, he's just doing it all on ability at the moment.
Winners continue for you and Jace, mate. Congratulations.
Yeah, cheers. It's good to be winning for Jason.
Mitchell Pateman there, winning jockey aboard a Gonna Go, taking out race number 6, another favourite getting up today.